At the White House, the president announces in a letter to the chairman of the Democratic National Committee that he will accept the nomination for a fourth term. His letter concludes, "Reluctantly, but as a good soldier, I repeat that I will accept and serve in this office if I am so ordered by the commander-in-chief of us all, the sovereign people of the United States." Vice President Wallace, back from China, reports to the White House. He's the big question mark in the coming convention, with a fight on his hands to snare the nomination again. Following in the wake of German troops retreating down the Norman Peninsula, this ingenious mine-beater saves many doughboys' lives. Chains explode hidden mines and create a path of safety for our advance. Yanks of the heroic 4th, 9th, and 79th clean out Nazi snipers hidden in the ruins of a Norman town. The furious Allied attack plays havoc with Nazi equipment and rounds up thousands of prisoners, including high-ranking officers. British, Canadian, and American troops have captured more than 50,000 Germans since the beginning of the campaign. Overhead, our air forces pound ceaselessly at enemy communications and equipment, as these newsreel, Air Force, and Signal Corps pictures show. Nazi supply ships on canals and rivers are set afire or sunk. Hitler's rail equipment is shot up. Hundreds of enemy planes are destroyed on the ground. One of the reasons the Luftwaffe is conspicuous by its absence. Secretary of War Stimson, 76 years old, on tour of the Italian war front, travels through war-torn towns to Rome on the first train to leave Naples for the capital since we moved in a month ago. In that short time, Army engineers made repairs. The flag-bedecked special train arrived safely, and it's congratulations for General Mark Clark. The same American flag that flew over our Washington Capitol the day of Pearl Harbor now waves proudly in Rome. Berlin, next. The Secretary of War takes genuine interest in our wounded boys. Conferences can wait. A great American doing a great job. Out of the grime and blood of Saipan emerges America's greatest single victory in the Pacific, control of the Marianas. The drive opens on Garapan, the capital. Jap headquarters blaze after savage attacks, and Marines add another trophy. Japs bomb our command post. These are Navy, Marine, and Signal Corps pictures. Saipan cost 15,000 American casualties, but the Jap garrison of 20,000 was virtually wiped out. Colonel Carlson, hero of Guadalcanal, just before he was wounded while rescuing an enlisted man. A bad omen for Tokyo. Airfields are already being put into operation for that 1,500-mile jaunt to Hirohito's capital. The distance is a cinch for our B-29 super fortresses. The men who fought the 25-day campaign have taken another giant step to Tokyo. Prime Minister Churchill, who with Britons is facing the robot blitz, visits an anti-aircraft installation designed to combat the menace. And there it is, the soulless killer. Mary Churchill is at her post of duty. The Prime Minister has warned Britons that even larger robots may be on the way. Already 2,700 have been announced killed. And this is the result. The bomb loaded with a ton of explosive has terrific concussive force. At the peace table, Winston Churchill will remember.